Let's talk about the next problem in vectors, which is about the addition of the two vectors. So over here we have a problem that says establish the following vector inequalities either geometrically or otherwise. Now the first inequality that we have to prove or establish is magnitude of a plus b vector is always less than or equal to magnitude of a plus magnitude of b. Second one is that magnitude of a plus b vector is always greater than or equal to modulus of magnitude of a minus magnitude of b. The modulus symbol present here is simply because we are interested in the number that comes out of the difference, not the sign. Now, if you carefully see this question, we are interested in the minimum value and the maximum value of vector sum a plus b in this problem. Also, in this problem, we'll be interchangeably using modulus of a and small a to represent the magnitude of a and modulus of b and small b to represent magnitude of b. So, as a student, you must be careful for the same. So now, let's talk about some assumptions that we'll be taking to solve this problem. So over here, we have two vectors a and b, which can be of arbitrarily any length, and the angle between them will be theta, which can again be either acute or obtuse. Geometrically, I can visualize them as two vectors a and b having either acute angle or obtuse angle theta between them. So tackling part one first, I can say that I have to prove this specific inequality. So I'll start off by writing the value of modulus of a plus b vectors. I know the formula. It simply comes out to be square root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta, where a and b are the magnitudes of the two vectors, theta is the angle between them. Now, the value of cos theta is maximum when cos theta is equal to 1 and angle theta is equal to 0 radians. Now, I say cos theta is maximum, and if a and b are unchanging quantities, this entire expression will be maximum when cos theta is maximum, and this entire expression will be minimum when cos theta is minimum. So, because cos theta is 1 and it is the maximum value, I can say that is the maximum possible value modulus of a plus b will take in its entire term when I am varying angle theta. So, in that situation, I can say magnitude of a plus b is always less than or equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab because this is the maximum possible value of modulus of a plus b. So, I can also see this expression here is a perfect square of a plus b. So, I can write it as modulus of a plus b is less than or equal to square root of a plus b whole square, which upon solution will give me an answer. Modulus of a plus b is always less than or equal to mod a plus mod b. Interesting thing here is that the value of modulus of a plus b is equal to mod a plus mod b only for a specific value when angle theta is equal to 0 radians. For all the other angle values, the value of mod a plus b is actually less than modulus of a plus modulus of b. The same idea will be more clear when we try to visualize this geometrically. So let's do that. Over here, I have two vectors a and b, and I'm going to change the angle between them from 0 to acute to obtuse. So let's consider first of all the angle as acute between them, and this S1 vector is the resultant I obtain after adding these two vectors using parallelogram law. Similarly, I increase the angle to an obtuse value and I obtain S2 vector as my final resultant. And finally, I make the angle to be 0 radians and then I add them, and this is the S3 vector I obtain. If I place all these three vectors one after the other, I can clearly see S3 vector is the longest among all the three. The reason for the same is that when the angle is 0 degrees, the sum value is maximum. For all the other angle values, the sum value is lesser. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now let's talk about the second part of this question, where we have to prove mod of a plus b is greater than or equal to modulus of magnitude of a minus magnitude of b. In this question, we are interested in the minimum value of the vector sum. Once again, I'll write the vector sum as modulus of a plus b as a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta whole square root over. The minimum value of this expression will come when cos theta takes its minimum value, which we know is minus 1, which comes at an angle of 180 degrees or pi radians. Now, I can say that this same expression, because it's minimum, for all the other values of mod a plus b will be actually more than this value. So, I can write mod of a plus b is always more than or equal to this minimum value, which comes when I put cos theta as minus 1. Now, after I've done that, this expression once again is a perfect square of a minus b. So I can write this as a minus b whole square square root. So after I solve this expression, I get modulus of a plus b is always greater than or equal to modulus of mod a minus mod b. Now once again, I have put this external modulus sign only because I'm interested in the value of difference, not in the sign of difference. Now, once again, if I look at this carefully, this expression will be exactly equal to this expression only for a specific angle, which is pi radians. For all the other angles, it will be more. That's exactly what is explained over here. Let's look at this geometrically. So over here, we have the same two vectors A and B that I'm going to add in multiple different ways and try to establish this relationship. So in the first case, I take two vectors A and B and create an acute angle between them. S1 vector is my resultant. In the second case, I make the angle obtuse and S2 vector is my resultant. In the third case, I make the angle exactly 180 degrees or pi radians, which makes these two vectors anti-parallel to each other. Now, the resultant of this is too small to draw over here. Now, if I compare all these three lengths, what I obtain is S2 vector is up to here, S1 vector is up to here, and S3 vector is very, very small. So, S3 vector's length is so small that every other resultant, when the angle is different, will be more than this S3 vector. So, recapping the entire idea of the question, the magnitude of the resultant we obtain after adding two vectors is maximum when angle between the vectors is 0 radians, and the maximum value is mod A plus mod B, the sum of the original two vectors. The magnitude of the resultant is minimum when the angle between the two vectors is pi radians and its value is mod A minus mod B. So, I hope these ideas are very, very clear to you.